Hello dear friends, it's me, Mr. Sanjay Kumar. Welcome back for learning 7th standard history subject. In this video, we are going to learn lesson number 3. The name of the lesson is Religious Synthesis. Dear friends, our country is a land of great diversity. India is known in the world for its unity in diversity. And it is our special characteristic. We speak different languages. We follow different customs and traditions. There are different landforms. There are different castes and religions found in our country. Though such a diversity is seen in our country, but all the people of our country, they live very peacefully, unitedly and happily in our country. Our country's constitution has adopted the principle of secularism. It means each citizen is free to practice any religion in our country. There are different religious people live in our country. They are Hindus, Muslims, Jains, Sikh, Buddhist, Isai, Christians, etc. All these people live peacefully, happily, unitedly in our country. On the basis of the principle of secularism, different streams of thoughts emerge in medieval period. Among them, Bhakti movement, Sikhism, Sufi sect have important place. They try to bring the religious synthesis in the life of the common people. It means that they try to coordinate the different religious ideas together with the devotion to God. Dear friends, now let's get information about Bhakti movement. It is believed that the Bhakti movement was originated in South India in the form of the Nayanar and the Alwars. The Nayanars were the devotees of Lord Shiva and the Alwars were the devotees of Lord Vishnu. There were also the people who believed that, who considered that Lord Vishnu and Lord Shiva, they are not different. They are one and the same. So they bring them together. They built Harihar idols. And these idols defeat half Vishnu and half Shiva. Such a Harihar idols were produced on a large scale in the medieval period. Dear friends, the great saint of this Bhakti movement preached the values like love of God, humanity, compassion, mercy, etc. Ramanuj and other acharyas strengthened the base of the Bhakti movement in South India. They told people that God is for all and God does not discriminate the people on the basis of caste, religion, sect or creed. Sant Ramanand strengthened the Bhakti movement in North India. Sant Kabir is one of the greatest saints of our country. Sant Kabir is a well-known saint in the Bhakti movement. He did not attach any importance to the places of pilgrimage, vratas or idol worship. For him, truth was God. He taught that all human beings are equal. He did not differentiate the people on the basis of different caste, religions, sect or creed. He tried to bring the unity among the Hindus and the Muslims. He also criticized very strongly the orthodox people in both the religions, that is in Hindus and Muslims. In Bengal, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu underlined the importance of Krishna Bhakti. Under his influence, Shankar Deva spread the Bhakti movement in Assam. Narsingh Mehta was a very famous Vaishnav Sant in Gujarat. He was an ardent devotee of Lord Krishna. Ardent means very enthusiastic or passionate saint. He gave the message of equality. Narsingh Mehta is known as the first poet of Gujarati language. The another great Sant of this movement is Sant Mirabai. Sant Mirabai also gave importance to the devotion of Lord Krishna. Actually, she belonged to the royal family of Mewar, but she refused the pleasure of the royal family and involved herself in the devotion to Lord Krishna. She composed the devotional verses in Rajasthani as well as Gujarati language. Dear friends, Sant Rohidas was another great son of this movement. He gave the message of equality and humanity. Surdas was a great poet of Hindi literature. He composed Sur Sagar on the subject of Krishna Bhakti. The another great Sant of this movement was Sant Tulsidas. Sant Tulsidas also composed the book Ramcharitmanas, which expresses the devotion to Lord Rama. Now, dear friends, let's get information about Sant Sri Basaveshwar. Sri Basaveshwar spread the Lingayat stream of thought in Karnataka. He opposed the caste system and stressed the dignity of labor. Kayakave Kailas is his famous saying. It means work is Kailas, that is, work is worship. He encouraged women's participation in his movement. Both men and women participated equally in the religious discussion which he conducted in the hall called Anubhav Mandapa. Sri Basaveshwar conveyed his teaching in the language of the people, that is Kannada, through the medium of Vachan literature. That's why his work had a great impact on the society. Now, dear friends, let's move on to the next point, that is Mahanubhav Pant. Mahanubhav Pant was founded by Sri Chakradhar Swami in the 13th century in Maharashtra. This sect preaches the devotion to Lord Krishna. Govind Prabhu was the guru of Chakradhar Swami. The followers of Chakradhar Swami included men and women, those belongs to the different caste and creed. He supported equality. He traveled the whole Maharashtra region, the different parts of Maharashtra, and taught the people in Marathi language instead of Sanskrit. This led to the development of the Marathi language. This sect mainly spread in Vidarbha and Marathwada regions of Maharashtra. Riddhipur in Vidarbha is an important place for this sect people. Dear friends, the followers of this Mahanubhav Pant compose different books. For example, Lila Charitra was compiled by Mahim Bhatt, describing the deeds of Chakradhar Swami. Dhavale was composed by the first Marathi poetess Mahadamba. Sutrapat and Drishtantapat was compiled by Keshobas. Vatsaharan of Damodar Pandit. Shishupal Vadh of Bhaskar Bhatt Borikar. And the last one, Rukmini Swayamvar of Narendra. Now, dear friends, let's get information about Guru Nanak. Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhism. He was the first guru of Sikh. His work has to be mentioned as the great attempt at religious synthesis. He visited at different places of both Hindus and Muslims. and at last he realized that the feeling of devotion is common everywhere. He tried to bring the unity among Hindus and Muslims. Many people were influenced by the teachings of Guru Nanak. The number of his followers increased day by day. The followers of Guru Nanak or the Sikh religion are called as Sikh, that is Shishyas or disciple. The Adi Granth is also known as Guru Granth Sahib, is the holy book of the Sikh. The Adi Granth includes the compositions by Guru Nanak, Sant Namdev, Sant Kabir and other saint. Guru Nanak was succeeded by 9 gurus of Sikh. Guru Gobind Singh was the 10th guru of Sikh. Now dear students, let's get information about Sufi sect. Sect is a group of people following specific ideals or leader. Sufi is a sect of Islam. Khwaja Moinuddin Chisti and Sheikh Nizamuddin Awliya were great Sufi saints. The Sufi saints believed that God is full of love and devotion. Their teachings include love for all human beings, meditation and simple living. Their teachings greatly influenced the Muslims as well as Hindus and contributed to bringing them closer.